So we can get part of the idea really simply by just replacing this equation with something that says for all state and action, the value at a state is bigger than or equal to this expression. This is essentially the Q value. For each SA, this is the Q value SA.
Mm-hmm.
So that's good. Now what we have to add that min thing. So what do we minimize here?
V.
So we can't just minimize V like that because that's a vector.
Right.
And we can't just minimize V sub S because S is unbound here, right? It's like which S? Which S do we want to minimize? So we kind of want to minimize all of them somehow. So the way we're going to write that, and this turns out to work, is minimize the sum. So that's going to put pressure on all the individual Vs to be as small as they can be so that it actually equals the max and isn't just an upper bound on the max.
Right, because if any one of them isn't, then you don't have the minimum sum.
Right, then you can always move it down a little bit.
Right.
So this actually is a linear program that is the solution to which is equivalent to the solution to the MDP. So we can just write down this linear program and give it to a linear program solver that runs in polynomial time, and boom, we get our values V sub S. How do we get our policy from that?
We just choose the action that always in expectation gives you the best value, just sort of one step look ahead.
Yeah, we choose the greedy policy with respect to that optimal value function. So this is cool. This is sometimes called the primal, you know, I guess because it lives out in the woods, representation of the linear program for solving MDPs. And this is a perfectly reasonable, this is very useful from a theoretical perspective. I haven't seen too many people really use linear programming to solve MDPs. It's got some overhead associated with it that seems to make it a little bit difficult to get it to run competitively with the other algorithms. But it's okay, especially if you have a really good linear programming package. And if you happen to have other kinds of linear constraints that you need to throw in, this is a very convenient way of solving slightly more difficult problems, MDPs plus a little bit of extra constraint. So does that make sense? You good with that?
Yeah, I'm good with that.
All right. I want to say one more thing about linear programming by switching away from the primal to what's called the dual. So linear programming has this nice property that you can actually, any linear program, you can change the constraints into variables and the variables into constraints, and you get a new linear program that's equivalent to the old one. So this is just true in general for linear programming. It's linear programming duality. And sometimes it's a really useful way of actually solving them and for putting bounds and constraints on the solutions. But in the context of MDPs, it actually does something kind of cool. So I want to show you that.
Okay. Is it going to be as cool as what happened when we did support vector machines?
I don't remember that.
We did the same thing. We wrote down a series of equations and we solved for the dual.
Nice. So yes, it'll be the same amount of cool as that.
Excellent. I look forward to it.